hence title of application of photocatalytic nanomaterials for durability of built environment. So Professor Moina Ghoshal, sir, are you there?
Yes sir, I am there.
Okay, just a minute.
Coming to the screen.
Yes, just a minute. Yes. Screen is visible.
A very good evening to you all.
But the slideshow is not. But the slideshow is not visible, sir.
Slideshow is not visible.
No, sir.
Now?
No, sir, yet. It's a folder is showing contents application of photocatalytic nanomaterials ICFI ICR TCM 2001 containing these files. Only a folder is showing there.
This one is showing, na?
Yes. Sir, I think you should stop the presentation and start it again.
Yes.
No, sir. No, it's same folder is showing.
Same thing is showing, no?
Yes, sir. Same thing is showing.
Coming?
No, sir. I think, sir, you have to open the PPT, then you have to share the PPT.
Okay, yes.
No, sir, it's your name that Professor Moina Ghoshal has started sharing. Yes, now it's coming, sir.
Thank you. Okay. A very good afternoon. Myself, Moina Ghoshal from IIT Shippur, consultant. And today my topic is photocatalytic nanomaterials for durability of built environment. Now, this is PML. What is durability? Some studies. Studies, consequences of inadequate durability, factors affecting the durability, role of nanomaterials like nanotitanium dioxide in the durability of concrete, my research, my results and conclusion. Now what is durability? Many organizations, many courts define durability in different ways. Indian standards say durable concrete is one that performs satisfactorily in the working environment during its exposure conditions, during service. And American Concrete Institute says durability of concrete is the ability to resist weathering action, chemical attack, abrasion, all those things, and any other cause of deterioration. So, when exposed to environment, durable concrete is likely to retain its original form. If the concrete is durable, quality and serviceability during its lifetime. but during concrete limits for water, these things, water ratio, cement to ratio, minimum cement, how the percent of cement, cover of the concrete, types of cement. Now there are various types of cement in the market, and presence of chloride and sulfate ions in concrete is a criteria for determining durability. Will come later. Concrete failure, some case. This is Akashdeep apartment of Mumbai, I think. Yeah, it failed due to durability. Now, failure is a pillar of success. Do we need such failure to succeed? In civil engineering, failure is not the pillar of success. You cannot get a pillar if the pillar fails. So, how to succeed? So, this is a Poonam Chambers, Mumbai collapsed 97 due to durability problems. Shiv Chandan, Andheri, Mumbai 94 also due to this. These are deep cracks formed in the acidic column. The reinforcement inside the concrete gets exposed because the concrete is indurable due to the use of beach sand. Beach sand is not proper for concreting. In our civil engineering, we use river sand, but these people use beach sand, and there's a problem of durable deep cracks in. Now, failure of Shivalik apartment in Calcutta, 95, 36 people, all durability problems. And 2010 due to monsoon rains, New Delhi apartment collapsed, 16 people died, all durability problems. So global scenario also we find many durability problems, like in Jerusalem, Israel, 2001, this supermarket collapse in Canada, this collapse of Nairobi, five-storied building, this South Korea departmental store collapse, 95, but 96, Hotel New World, Singapore collapsing, Dhaka recently 2013, Rana Plaza collapsed due to port construction practices, killing 150 people. So this is the durability problem. And what are the outcomes of inadequate durability? Loss of strength of concrete. Concrete liable to be affected by deterrents, that the outside chemical may attack concrete, corrosion of river, that the reinforcement bars may corrode, loss of serviceability, unpleasant appearance, danger to persons and property, expensive repair cost, poor perception of concrete as a material, poor perception of the people involved, agency involved, reduction of service life, and external risks like weathering, attacks by nature, chemicals, bacteria, all those things. Now, this is a house in our locality. See, it's the columns cracked up, the slabs falling, the beams broken, all due to inadequate durability. The factors affecting durability of concrete: cement content, and I just told types of cement, water quality, and water the water we use in concrete, the permeability of water into the concrete. More permeable concrete, more indurability. Temperature of the atmospheric and the core of the concrete, carbonation of the concrete, alkali aggregate. The aggregate present in the stones present in the reaction, they react with the alkali. Alkali is the cement, calcium hydroxide, and it also gives rise to durability issues. Sulfide and chloride attack, and sulfur attack is discussed heavily in this paper. I will come later on. Organic acids also affect durability. Aggregate quality, aggregate is bad. If it reacts with the alkali, then it concrete is indurable. Concrete compaction, if you do not compact concrete well during the casting, it will be affecting durability. Curing, if you do not water the concrete up to 7 days from the time of casting, it will affect the durability. Moisture present in the atmosphere and in the concrete, it will affect durability. Abrasion, wetting and drying. Abrasion means the friction, wetting and drying cycles. We not go details here. Freezing and thawing at the outside countries. Now, cement affects the strength of concrete. Good OPC or ordinary porcelain cement, we call it in engineering terms, engineering terms, plus water gives to CSA gel. This calcium silicate hydrate gel is a complex compound which gives the strength of the concrete, plus a calcium hydroxide is formed. Calcium. This is the most dangerous thing because it takes up the external agencies, it takes up the external chemicals, and it deteriorates the concrete. It reacts with the external chemicals like chloride and sulfate, and it deteriorates the concrete. Will come later. Now, cement hydration, cement reacts with water for 1 year, more than 1 year, the reaction goes on. But in our code, we take the 28 days, the standard, the 28 days, what strength the cement concrete gives, we take it as a standard. The Indian standard specifies, and more people standards, all world standards also specify this. But cement hydration continues. Now, durability versus the microstructure of concrete. What is the relation between durability and the microstructure? Microstructure consists of aggregates, that is sand and cement, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, hydrated cement paste, and the entrapped air voids. What the air voids in the cement concrete matrix. The factors affecting this is the hydrated cement CSA gel. Ettringite is formed, is a crystalline product which comes later. Monosulfate is formed. Gel porosity and capillary pores. How many capillary pores are there? Many capillary pores. Many. The permeability will be more. Less capillary pores, the permeability will be less. And entrapped air voids. Air voids have a role to play in delivery. And transition zone means your cement paste and the stone surface. This is the transition zone between the cement and the stone. This is the aggregate. Aggregate means the stone, interfacial zone, the bulk cement pores. CH is the calcium hydrate. This is the ettringite and CH is the calcium hydroxide. This is the microstructure. I have no time, so I am in a hurry. Now, structure of damaged concrete. Visible cracks in hydrated cement paste and aggregates due to volume change. To understand cracks, we need to look at the microstructure. And also, structure of damaged concrete consists of the alkali-silica reaction. If it is more alkali-silica reaction, we get more this transition zone. And transition zone expands, and it expands the concrete, it cracks open the concrete. Frost action, if water is there, water freezes in the capillary pores, it becomes ice, it tears open the concrete, and it like sulfur and chloride duct, this reaction products forming hydrated calcium products, mainly with OPC, with glycogen, and ESPN. This sulfur and chloride duct, these chemicals are formed, I'll come later, and which expands and tears open the concrete, with forming large cracks, and durable concrete is reduced. And porosity permeability leads to corrosion of rebar. The corrosion gets rusted. The steel bars in the concrete, it gets rusted and it leads to undurable concrete. Now, see, sulfate and chloride of concrete is my paper's mainly topic. And chloride attack we get from the seawater. Seawater, because it is salty water, its chlorine ions are there. Also, sulfate ions are there. But in the inland areas, sulfate ions are mainly there due to our the pollution of the industries and pollution of the vehicles. Sulfate, we get primary sulfur ions, and we convert gets converted to secondary sulfur ions, and then details is there. Not but does what attack it concrete. The calcium hydroxide, I told you, the treacherous part, it reacts with the magnesium and then sodium sulfate producing calcium silicate hydrate. No, not calcium, calcium sulfate, the secondary gypsum. This calcium sulfate, it reacts with the tricalcium aluminate present in the cement. That is giving us to ettringite. I just told you ettringite, and it contains the water molecule. And see, this water molecule will have a great role in playing with the nanomaterials in reacting the nanomaterials to prevent this attack, chemical attack from the external sources. Sulfur mechanism, what happens? This calcium hydroxide, it reacts with magnesium, the sulfate ion, it gives rise to gypsum, secondary gypsum, causing of course. And then it reacts with the cement, hydrated calcium aluminate, the C3A, and it gives rise to our secondary ettringite, which is a crystalline product, and it expands and it tears open our concrete. This concrete disintegrates. Now, the ettringite formation, this is our crystalline ettringite formation. Signs of sulfate attack, extensive cracking and expansion, damage started at edges and corners, mainly edges and corners, ettringite crystal formation and deposition cracks. Like cracks get deposited by ettringite crystal. And whitish appearance is formed on the surface where inland and coastal polluted areas, mainly sulfate. I told you inland, also coastal, because seawater also contains chloride and sulfate, mainly there. Chemical reaction, ettringite formation, expansion mechanism, crystallized dispersion theory, already told, swelling theory, and you get cracks. See, this is a schematic diagram, sulfate plus water. This solution penetrates, expands, tears from ettringite formation, and it attacks the reinforcement, the iron bars inside. And this is a stage, ultimate stage. Now, chloride attack. Chemical reaction, calcium hydroxide, that treacherous part I told you, reacts with the sodium chloride, forms calcium chloride, and sodium hydroxide, hydroxyl is formed. And this calcium chloride reacts with tricalcium aluminate present in the cement. And it gives rise to calcium chloroaluminate, also a crystalline product, See, hydrated calcium aluminate, yes, which calcium chloroaluminate, which tears open our cement matrix, and it disintegrates the cement concrete matrix. So, signs of 40% of all failures of concrete is due to chloride attack. It corrodes the reinforcement, whereas sulfur does not. And where mainly coastal areas, chloride attack. Chemical reaction, calcium chloroaluminate is formed. This is called feeder salt formation, expansion mechanism, crystalline theory, told, swelling theory. Now, this is a schematic diagram of chloride attack. Sorry, just one second. and solution, cryo solution, it details the river, passive layer. Passive layer means you cannot break open the river, a small film layer is formed in the cement concrete when you place the reinforcement inside the concrete. But if this chloride ions is present, it destroys that film layer, and what happens, this rust or this corrosion of the layer is formed, or the steel is formed. Now, nano titanium dioxide plays a vital role in the durability of concrete due to its self-healing properties. What happens in the sun, it oxidizes, or rather it oxidizes the viruses, the bacteria, the organic molecules, and in presence of carbon water vapor and carbon dioxide also. This is a paper from review on heterogeneous photocatalytic discharge of waterborne, airborne, and it is also viral because it can oxidize also this COVID-19 virus also, this paper says. 2020 paper. Now this is our
this video will demonstrate the mechanism and principles of photocatalysis. In photocatalysis, when light energy is irradiated from the sun or other fluorescent lighting onto titanium dioxide, a strong power of decomposition is generated on the titanium dioxide coated surface. Because of its properties, microorganisms and viruses are continuously decomposed until they become harmless. The effect of photocatalysis is almost permanent. Let's look at how this works. When light energy is irradiated onto the surface of titanium dioxide, electrons are released. The released electrons bind with oxygen to become superoxide anion. The surface of the titanium dioxide becomes positively charged and takes electrons from moisture in the air. The moisture in the air that has lost electrons becomes hydroxyl radical. The hydroxyl radical is often referred to as the detergent of the troposphere because it reacts with many pollutants, decomposing them through cracking, often acting as the first step to their removal. The superoxide anion and hydroxyl radicals, by their power of oxidation destruction, decompose organic compounds such as COVID-19, unwanted bacteria, H1N1, fungus, salmonella, and offensive odors, turning them into water or other harmless substances and disperse them into the atmosphere. This is exactly what happens when using the shield in.
Now, what is nano? Just you saw this, the previous video, this when sunlight falls, electrons are released, it gets converted into superoxide ions and it takes up electrons from the water and it oxidizes. Now nano titanium dioxide has this power, photocatalytic power. Now, what is nano?
Of scale.
See, this video will just explain you what is nano. 10 to the power minus 9 meter, so small, more small than a human hair, or grain of salt, or amoeba,
the amoeba, which you might remember from biology, the paramecium,
a human egg,
the larger cells like the human
or
egg,
the sperm, the micro level, the sperm.
The smaller scales. This is a micron scale.
In mitochondria, also at the micro level, micrometer level.
Powers our cells, and now
then you come to your virus, scale, HIV, virus. Nanometer level. This is the level of nano, 10 to the minus 9 meter. Now, how nano? See, it's a letter from Benjamin Franklin, who is stated of inventor of electricity, some say. His letter says, at a large pond I fetched out a quart of oil and dropped a little of it on the water. I saw it spread itself with surprising swiftness upon the surface. The oil, though not more than a teaspoonful, spread amazingly and extended itself gradually quarter of the point, perhaps half an acre. What happens? He dropped a drop of oil on the water, on the pond, and amazingly he saw it grows to half an acre. So that thing, oil is immiscible with water, and what happens, the spread is related to the nanoparticles of the oil. The oil spread its maximum level up to its nanoparticle limit, and there it remains. So this is the nano, the concept of nano. So why nano? Nano, suppose we consider a 1 centimeter cube. You break it down into 1 millimeter cube, we get 60 centimeter square total surface area. If you break it in 1 nanometer cube, we get 6 into 10 to the power 7 centimeter square surface area, total surface area, such a huge surface area. Increasing surface area, you get atomic efficiency, and also if the surface area increases, your power of cement hydration in the cement matrices increases much more manifold because of the presence of so much surface area. That is, your hydrogen project will increase, your strength is increase due to the increase in surface area. Now Indians use nanotechnology. Many people do not know this. 22,000 years ago, our Ajanta Ellora paintings and our Tipu Sultan sword has been said of this of nanomaterials. And also this is Robert Carl Jr. who got Nobel Prize in 2000 decade, and he just claimed this thing, and he did his experiment in his lab, and he says this Indian knew this nanotechnology 2000 years ago. Robert Carl Jr. is the inventor of graphene, you know, and also Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, other explained of, you know, how nanotechnology has come in, it is the field of our future. When Bharat Ratna said this. Now, nanotitanium dioxide, it has got excellent self-cleaning properties, due to oxidation of organic materials, and it improves the complete strength of concrete under adverse conditions. And nanotitanium dioxide is most used in our cosmetic industry, and it is also used, you see, this is a conventional glass, water is there in the glass, water sticks into the conventional glass, but when you use nanomaterials in the glass, nanotitanium dioxide is self-cleaning. The process you see here, this is a dirt, and it oxidizes the dirt, and it just self-cleans it. Now, nanotitanium dioxide can be manufactured from waste. These are some papers, I have not done details. From waste means from built environment waste, like paint waste, from secondary waste, from agriculture waste materials, all those things. From food waste also it can be used, nanotitanium dioxide. Titanium dioxide are applied in coatings and fabrications. Coatings examples of our foreign people have done for Rome, KLDB, Fort Bridge in London, London's Olympic Stadium. All these have used paints, Narita Airport Terminal in Japan, all these have used nanomaterial in paints. Fabrication is a Jubilee Church of Rome. They have used nanotitanium dioxide in its outside mortar, cement sand mortar, and see this, the whiteness you see. And see, this is a standard concrete, standard application of concrete. And this is a nanotitanium dioxide cement formulated concrete. See the difference in the color, the black color and the white color. Painting restorations have been done using nanotitanium dioxide. And see the usage, China is using, Asia Pacific is using 25%, 21%. Europe is using 21%, so its usage is growing as per some estimate. My research, mixing of nanotitanium dioxide with cement does not yield any result because it does not mix with water. So what I did, I mixed this nanotitanium dioxide in a polymer called polycarboxylate ether, PCE, in standard form, a latest generation polymer, and and I applied ultrasonication or ultrasonic energy, external ultrasonication. This is my application. And then after it got mixed, this is also carbon nanotubes, but it became white. And then I applied in the mortar. See, this is a black mortar, the gray mortar, the normal mortar, ordinary mortar. This is a nanotitanium dioxide applied. See, its color is white. Now mixing, you see this video. Of course, this is of nanotitanium dioxide, this carbon nanotube, but actually, you just see the mixing, how does I mix in my laboratory, the nanomaterials. This is after ultrasonication, it is not immiscible with water.
Thank you.
violating its original contacting me. Now it could be done as well, contacting IP. So that the mixing is better. Sir, I'm putting in the cast mold, the cement, sand, water, and nanomaterial mixture, the composite. Then I'm putting it in an external vibration or external compaction. Test it at 728 days. And now, test in the MgCl2 magnesium chloride and sulfate exposure. What I did, I put these cubes into a MgCl2 or MgCl2 solution. The solution I made by adding the molecular weight of this MgCl2 or MgCl2 into 1 liter of water, and then I put it under diffuse sunlight in our laboratory. This is a photograph. Sorry. And our properties of nanotubes, I got nanotubes dioxide from Kerala Minerals and Metals Limited. This percentage is 97%, neutral content is 98%, that is mainly neutral type of nanotubes dioxide. pH is neutral, average particle size 30 to 40 nanometer, moisture content 2 to 1.75 as per the manufacturer supplies literature, bulk density 0.31 gram per cc, and water source insoluble. This is the exact image I got from the multi-crystalline nanotubes dioxide material from our lab. It is, and my test results are 28 days. I am getting with the ordinary cement composite, I am getting 31.89, but after adding nanotubes dioxide, I am getting 12.5% increase at 28 days. And after adding 1%, this is at after adding 2.5%, and this increase. And at 1 year, this is a 37.5% increase at 1% nanotubes dioxide. And but if you add more nanotubes dioxide, the nanoparticles agglomerate and it do not get your the desired result. So 1% is the optimized quantity per weight of cement of nanotubes dioxide I am using here.
Yeah.
See the test results.
So far, I think
this is increase. 37% increase at 65 days. Microscopic analysis, this is the ordinary sample, this is the nanotubes dioxide. So hydration process is more uniform, more heat of hydration has been generated, that's why the holes are there. But the air cracks is there, and no such types of cracks are appearing, but more hydration products are there because of illumination. Now this is magnesium chloride. 90 days I am not getting increased by 1% nanotubes dioxide, but 100 days, see 49% increase by addition of 1% of nanotubes dioxide in cement complete in chloride exposure. This is a test result, say 90 days, this is an increase, 49% increase at 65 days. 90 days it was decreasing. Now test results in magnesium sulfate ions, 90 days I am getting a decrease, but 65 days, 100 days I am getting 64% increase. See the increase in magnesium sulfate, which very deterrent in for concrete, the sulfate ions. See this graph, see 54% increase at 65 days. So conclusion, my conclusion, there are many types of cement and they are good for, one cement is good for chloride, resisting chloride attack, another cement is good for resisting Sulfur alloy, the slag and Portland pozzolana ash based cement. So PPC cement or PHC cement is called in the market, but cannot even that side. 1% by weight of cement optimization is good for reducing the both chloride and sulfur alloy. Also, the nanotube alloy is more durable and sustainable because it can be produced from our waste materials. This is a picture showing nano durable, workable, is more workable, more chemical resistant, more give superior finish because you saw the color. And it's a green product and it can be synthesized from the waste. So if you have any question, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your nice presentation. So any question regarding the discussion? Any question regarding the discussion? Okay, I think there is no question. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your presentation.
Thank you.
So here our afternoon oral presentation session is over. There are four speakers are there and all of them are present there. Now I would like to invite Dr. Sangeeta Sen, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemical Science, IZAR, Kolkata.